Well, hello to you. Welcome to Word Studies with Pastor. It is an honor to have you a part of this broadcast today. Now, let me say right up front, I'm having a few throat issues, all right? This is my third time to start this recording and I had to stop. So what's going to happen, all right, is if I have to get a drink of water, stop a second, that's okay. I'm going to keep going this time, all right? So, and I'm believing the Lord just to get through it anyhow. I think third time is a charm, but I want you to know that. Still having a few issues, but it's going to be all right. But thank you for being a part of this, okay? It's just a joy to be able to minister God's word no matter what venue. And I've always considered it an honor. I've been doing this for quite some time, and it really, you know, it doesn't matter whether I'm in a conference, camp meetings, whatever. It's always been such an honor. Size of crowds, irrelevant. It's God's word going forward that blesses me so much, and it's an honor to be invited to do it, just like it is now. You've honored me by tuning in to Word Studies with Pastor. And those of you that are commenting, those of you that are enjoying it, thank you. Those that are sharing it, what you're doing is you're taking this word and you become a part of putting it out there by sharing it with your friends. Now, let me say, I'm not talking about sharing it where someone would get to know me. That has nothing to do with it. I want them to get to know the Word of God or to be blessed, because there's times that, and I believe not just times, I believe all the time, a particular word goes forward and it speaks directly to someone. And just maybe some of your friends needs to hear something that I'm going to say this evening. And so share it. Just hit that share button and let them know. Okay? Now, let me take just a moment to invite you into our services here at Messenger Church at 602 Summit Road, Fenton, Missouri, for this Sunday's live service at 10 a.m. I'm going to be ministering on the subject, What is Next on the Horizon. From my past two sermons, I've dealt with what is coming. In those two sermons, I talked about what's coming to the present church, to us right now on planet Earth. I am of the school of thought that God is going to manifest himself in such a supernatural way until, as one prophet said, if you were told, you wouldn't even believe it. It's going to be so great and so mighty. Now understand something. I do not believe it's going to be long and drawn out. I believe it's going to be a suddenly. All right, it's going to be a quick move of God. Isaiah said, will you not know it? In other words, something's going to spring forth. Something's coming, but it's going to be a suddenly in this last day. Now, Peter said something over in Acts 2 when he, after he experienced the infilling of the Holy Ghost, and then he stands up to preach to thousands, and he said, this is that was spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. Now, what blessed me about that was that in the last days, God said, I will pour out, not trickle, not drop, but pour out of my spirit upon, and I love this, all. In other words, no one's going to be left out of what God said he's going to be doing. And so we, my friend, are in the last days. And this sermon or this series that I start Sunday, What is Next on the Horizon, I'm going to give you biblical truths that will lay out for you exactly what's going to happen. Now, I can't tell you when, because the word says no one knows when, not even Jesus, just the Father. But I can tell you and I will show you some events, some things that are taking place that adds clarity to the nearness of his coming. So that's Sunday morning, 10 o'clock. If you miss that, of course, you can tune in at 10:30, between 10:30 and 10:45, because we have a little bit of a gap sometimes because of the what is going on in the earlier part of the live service. So just hang with us. Go to those places where you can watch us on Facebook or YouTube.com/ Messenger Church. Hang with us for a few minutes. If we're not on at exactly 10:30, it will be coming. So you can watch us then or get us later on in the week because it's always recorded. There's always the ability to play back whether YouTube or whether on Facebook. One other thing before I take you into the book. All right. We have a 24-hour prayer ministry right here at Messenger Church. 24 hours a day. We have a group of people that will pray over your request. If you would love to call us, you would love to turn into that request to our prayer coordinator, all right, which is Sherry Blair, then all you've got to do is call 314-602-2706. Once again, 314-602-2706. Doesn't matter where you're from, doesn't matter how far away you are, prayer has no limit. It will reach, all right, wherever it needs to. So give us a call. I'll share that number with you again at the end of the broadcast today. So those are some things that are going on. We invite you to come and be a part of Messenger Church. God is moving in this house. I just can't tell you how great the presence of God is in either service, even in 1 hour from now. You're listening to this at 6 o'clock Central Time. At 7 o'clock, I'm going to be going right into the Word of God right here live on a Wednesday night service. I'm ministering actually on a new series called The Journey, also on Wednesday. The Journey is going to be dealing with the fact that we have a prepared place that Jesus went to prepare, but from now to then, from now to the point of getting there, I'm going to be giving some knowledge, some information on what needs to be done or who you are to assure you that you will overcome the problems of the situations that you're faced with every day. That's at 7 o'clock tonight. All right, so God bless you. Let me get into the Word. I'm ministering on the subject of come on up. Come on up. I believe, and I really believe this, that God is calling His church to a higher level. I believe God is calling us to that next level, that place to where clarity, a revelation is there, where God can talk to us, God can give us direction, God can bless us, God can minister to us as He prepares to minister through us. I've often said that we are not containers, we are dispensers. I kind of think I have the Holy Spirit to not rebuke me, but to enlarge my understanding a little bit more on the way into the church today. Because my mind was on that. And of course, I'm praying and I'm praying often, God, I want to be used of you. I want your glory. I want your presence. I want your power. I don't want you just to flow to me, but flow through me. But then I was given this understanding this morning. We are containers. We are reservoirs, all right? And I got to thinking about maybe a river that has been dammed up, all right? But every river that is dammed up and it builds up this great reservoir, this great lake, has a spillway, all right? It has a way for water to flow to keep the river flowing. And so the Lord said, and I feel this so strong in my heart, you are a reservoir. You are a container of my glory, but you have a spillway. You have that flows out of you. And then I was reminded of what Jesus said. Out of your innermost being in John 7, out of your innermost being shall flow rivers of living water. And so though we are containers of God's glory, all right, yet there's a spillway. There's a place for it to flow out that others can be blessed. And I believe God is calling us up higher where He can not only speak to us, but through us. And He will say things that will bless us, encourage us, and move us. And as we're moved, there will be a hunger to share it with someone else. If you're not hungry to share what God is doing in your life, I kind of question what that is. All right. So I just think when something good comes, you want other people to know about that good. So that's what I'm talking about here on Word Studies. And what I've done is I've taken you into Exodus, the 20th or the 19th chapter and the 20th verse, where God spoke to Moses and told him to come on up. Moses, come on up here. and come up to the top of the mountain. And in other words, I've got something I want to say to you. I don't want you distracted by what's going on down there. I don't want you hindered by what other people are doing and they were doing stuff. I don't want you to be bothered by them. I want that come apart place. Come, and I want to talk to you. And then what the word says in that 20th verse, it said Moses went up. Now, nowhere in there do I find to where Moses hesitated. Nowhere do I find where he wanted to debate with God, where he said, well, God, I hear you, God, but let me go take care of this. Let me go do this. Let me go. No, I don't find where he did any of that. He had a word from God, and instantly he went up. Let me tell you something. We need to get our priorities all in order. When God talks, this is priority above everything else. When God's word becomes a rhema or a speaking, it's already a speaking word, don't sit around debating God. Do what God tells you to do, you see. And that's what Moses did. He obeyed. Say that. Obey. He obeyed. Now, let me give you something here. I'm going to be giving you the fruit of obedience here in a minute. But notice what Isaiah said. Over in Isaiah, the first chapter, if you'll be willing and obedient, you'll eat the good of the land. Now, we've got the cart all mixed up before the horse. We want the good of the land before we ever obey. That's not what God said. God said, if you'll be willing to do it and you'll obey me, then you're going to eat the good of the land, all right? So don't judge God by the stuff that comes or doesn't come. Don't look around and look at what God's doing for someone else and saying, God, they really got it good. You love them more than me. No. You don't know their level of obedience and you don't know their level of goodness, okay? And really, it's none of your business. God's blessing them, but there's always a purpose, a reason, a foundation for it. What you've got to do is deal with your own self and quit trying to deal with everybody else. Get your own house in order. Don't worry about cleaning up behind someone else's door. Take care of your own. God said, if you'll be willing and obedient, you'll eat the good of the land. Now, I love that. And I appreciate God's blessings on me and mine. But now, let's go over real quickly, not too quick, but kind of quick, into Deuteronomy and go into the 28th verse. I want to show you in this, all right, what I call the very fruit of obedience. Notice it. Deuteronomy 28, 1 through 14, talking to the man of God here. Now it shall come to pass. Don't you like that? Now it shall come to pass. If, there's that conjunction, there's that one word. That one word, if, is used over 1,700 times in God's word, where God is laying out a process. If you'll do this, then you'll see this, or this will happen. Okay, go back. If you'll be willing and obedient, you'll eat the good of the land. So he gave a process to get the good of the land. The process was to be willing and obedient. Now, it shall come to pass if you diligently obey the voice of the Lord your God. In other words, you obey. You're committed to it. You're faithful in doing it. You never hesitate to do it. You're diligent in your pursuit. You're diligent in your obedience. The voice, all right, if you're to obey the voice of the Lord your God and to observe, which means to do. To observe, notice this, all his commandments. If you are diligent, if you are willing, if you are careful to obey, to observe his commandments, which I command you today, that the Lord your God will set you high above all the nations of the earth. Okay, now there, right there, is one of the fruits of obedience. If, all right, you are diligent in obedience to the voice of the Lord your God to do what the Word of God tells you to do, then you're going to live high above, get this, high above all the nations of the earth. And the nations of the earth he's talking about right here are heathen, non-believers, people that don't serve God, don't love God, don't obey God. As a matter of fact, they tried to kill as many of the Israelites as they could or they were going to on the journey to the land of promise. And God says, you're going to live above the fray. You're going to live above all of that if you will obey me. Now notice this. I love this. And all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you. Why? Because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. Now in the following verses, he gives a long list of blessings. But what we've got to grab a hold of, and I'm going to look at some of them. Before we look at them, you've got to remember that. He said, all of them, not one of them, not two of them, not three. But he said, every blessing I'm going to bring to your attention, you're going to have it if you will obey me. And don't forget that word, diligent. Don't forget that word. If you'll keep obeying me, if you'll keep doing what my word says. Now, I don't want to disturb you, and I don't want to upset you, and I don't want to lose you right here. But I need you to listen to me. Be diligent. It doesn't matter what other people are offering you. It doesn't matter what other people are saying. It doesn't matter when someone says, well, God doesn't require that anymore, or you don't have to do that anymore. Okay, if you had to lay it aside when you first found the Lord, what makes you think you can pick it up and do it again now? Okay, if God required it of you 10 years ago, why do you think that he's not requiring it now? You think you're better now than you were then? No, you're not. You're not. It is Jesus in you that makes you who you are anyhow. But we need to understand, obey him diligently. Keep on obeying what thus saith the word of God. And he said, all of my blessings are going to be yours. Okay? That's what he said. All of these blessings shall come upon you. I like this. All of these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. In other words, the Lord said, if you'll obey me, you can't even outrun my blessing. If you'll obey me, I will run you down with my blessings. I'll overtake you. You can't run fast enough to get away from my blessing. You can't run fast enough. You can't hide. If you obey my word, you're going to be blessed. And I will overtake you wherever you are. Doesn't that make you want to get up and run around the building? Amen. God said, you do what I tell you to do, and you're going to be blessed. Notice this, third verse. Blessed shall you be in the city. Blessed shall you be in the country. Why'd he do that? Why'd he do that? Because he wants you to know no matter where you live, he's going to bless you. You may live in Los Angeles. You may live out in the country down in South Alabama. God said, I'm going to bless you wherever you are. If you obey me, always go back. Always tag in that second verse. That second verse is the preface for everything that's going to go on the rest of the verses. God said, Moses, I want you to come on up. I want you to get up here where I am. I want you to get higher. I've got some things I want to share with you. I've got some things I want to talk to you about. And he's now saying, I'm going to bless you if you do everything I tell you to do. And I'm going to run you down with my blessing. I know I've run out of time, and this is not a good place to stop. Maybe it is. All right. But there's people listening to me right now. You've been trying to figure out how can I walk in God's blessings? How can I receive more of the Lord? It hinges off of one word, obedience. If you'll be willing and obedient, you'll eat the good of the land. Now, God's calling us up to a higher place. I believe it's a place of clear thinking, of clarity, a place to where it's just us and God. Now, Joshua went partway with Moses, but there came a point where Moses said, okay, Joshua, you stay here. You're good company. You're someone I can lean on. You're someone that's faithful to me as a leader, but I need you to stop right where you are. I've got to go a little higher. The demand is not for you to go there right now. Later on it would have been, but not now. I need to be alone with God. Sometimes you need to get right by yourself and just you and God. Cleanse yourself of all of what everyone else has said. Take a Bible, take the Word of God with you, but get before God and let God begin to talk to you. I guarantee you, He'll show you what He has for you, but it will always hinge off of being obedient. He's calling us up higher. I gotta go. Don't forget, if you need prayer, you give us a call at 314-602-2706. 24 hours a day, we'll pray for you. Are you hearing me? Come on up higher. Come on. God is saying that to you, your family, anyone else, come on up higher. If you're in our area, in just a little while, I'll be ministering on the subject of the journey. I love you. Thank God for you. I'll talk to you next Wednesday at the very same time.